What's up guys, my name is Adrian Rivera and today I'm going to show you how to use EQ in FL Studio properly and precisely so you can get something that sounds like this.
Test because I'm the best. Yes. Yes!
And make it sound a little bit more like this.
Test because I'm the best. Yes. Yes!
Alright guys, so if you like this video, make sure to leave a like. If you haven't already, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. And guys, it's crazy. We're growing so fast. I just reached 300 subscribers yesterday. And at the beginning of June, I just reached 200 subscribers. So in the span of a month, I've gained 100 subscribers. So make sure you subscribe and let's keep that momentum going. Now, I'm going to make this tutorial quick but effective, so you guys can understand everything you need to make EQ. I got to go to dinner with my family at 8:30 and it's currently 7:24, so I have about an hour to make this video. But without a further ado, before I go into FL Studio, I want to explain a little bit more about what EQ is and help you guys understand it a little bit better. So let's get on with it. All right, so as you can see here, we have a drawing of our EQ graph. Now we have the vertical line right here and the horizontal line right here. Our horizontal line relates to frequency, which is measured in hertz, and our vertical line relates to level, which is measured in decibels. Now, frequency, when we're talking about frequency, we're talking about pitch, because frequency is related to pitch, so we're talking about the pitch of our audio. And when we're talking about level, level is related to volume, so we're talking about the volume of our audio. Now, your graph might end up looking different than this. This is just a little example that I'm writing here. But when we're talking about EQ, we're not changing the pitch of our audio at all. What we're actually doing is we're changing the volume of certain pitches of the audio to accentuate frequencies that we think sound good and to lower the volume of other frequencies that we don't really want to hear as much. So to give you an example, if we're making... if we don't want to hear a lot of low end in our audio, what we would do is we would make a point around negative 10 or negative 20 decibels, wherever we want to cut it off, and we would put that point in the lower frequency range. So when we make this point right here, instead of a straight horizontal line, our EQ graph is gonna look more something like this. This is showing us that a lot of the low end volume is brought down so that we don't hear it as much in our audio. And if we wanted to raise the volume of certain frequencies, we'd put another point, let's say around 10 decibels. So now our graph would look something like this. And essentially that's all EQ is.
Alright guys, so we're in FL Studio. I actually didn't end up finishing the video yesterday. I just went out to eat because we left a little bit earlier. The food was good. I'm sorry guys. But it's okay because I am back and I am better than ever. And I am ready to show you guys how to use EQ. So first things first, I just want to get this out of the way. The majority of the time you're going to be using this section of the EQ and this section to do all of your EQing. All this little stuff on the bottom here and over here is just kind of extra. You will be using this a little bit, but majority of the time it's just this and this. So first things first, let me get the extra stuff out of the way. This is kind of just how you manage your EQ. This little button right here is to show you the icons. So if you click it out, you still can manage the EQ like this, but it just makes the icons a little less noticeable. So I usually have them clicked on all the time. You can click them off. It's all just preference. This button right here is for high quality playback. If you don't have that strong of an audio card, then you can click this off just to make things load a little bit faster. I think you're gonna be fine just having this checked on. These are just a little bit of extra settings that you can mess around with. Right here is your monitor. If you see, if I click play,
test cause I'm the best. Yes, yes!
You'll see all the different frequencies that your audio file goes through when running through the EQ. You can choose to monitor the output of the audio, the input of the audio, or just no monitor at all. So if we click input,
test cause I'm the best. Yes. Yes!
You see the audio of everything being input into the EQ. But if you click output,
test cause
if you edit anything in the EQ,
test cause I'm the
you'll see it on the monitor. This little thing right here called compare. In all honesty, I'm not exactly sure what this is for because I've never seen anybody else use it and I've never used it before. But from the looks of it, what I'm guessing is it allows you to save different states of the EQ so that you can flip back and forth between the different states you made and just kind of compare different types of EQ. Now, there's probably a use for that. I've never used it myself and I've never really seen anybody else use it, but you can use it if you want to. You just might have to learn a little bit about that by yourself. Now, over here to the right, we have our bands. And each of these colors controls the different bands we have on our monitor. Now, if we move one of these middle squares, you can see that it moves the band in our monitor, but we can also just grab the band itself and move it around here. And that's usually what I do. But when I'm fine tuning, I use this little slider so I can get to the decibel level that I feel is right for my EQ. And if you look at the top left corner of FL Studio, you'll notice that up here, it shows you the decibel level of the frequency band. Let me just reset that. And each of these controls the different types of frequency bands you have. So if you notice, when I bring this up, this moves up. When I bring this down, this moves down. I right click, click reset, it resets both of these. And you could also just reset over here. So once you know one of these frequency bands, you basically know all of them. This one right here is the overall gain. So you can up the volume of everything or lower the volume of everything. And up here we have the different band types or filter types. If you click and drag, you'll see that you flip through these different types of filters. The ones you're mainly probably gonna be using are low pass, high pass, peaking, high shelf, and low shelf. And I'll show you how each of those look like in a minute. Down here, we have the band frequency. And if you see, when we move this around, our band moves on the horizontal axis. So if you see, if we move this left, the band frequency turns to the left. And if we move this to the right, the band frequency turns to the right. Below that, we have the bandwidth. So if I move this up, you guys see this a little bit more. You can kind of think of it as the intensity of the band. And up here, we have the steepness. So if we move that around, you see the different types of steepness. It's kind of like bandwidth, but if you compare that, you'll see that bandwidth has these little slopes up here and down here. So they're used for different reasons. Now, if you right click one of these tokens, you'll see that you can reset it. There's type, which shows you which type of filter you could put onto your frequency band. And then right here is the steepness. Now, let me go back and show you how the different types of filters work. You can see that this low shelf filter works like a slide. When you bring it up, everything to the left is brought up. When you bring it down, everything to the left is brought down. And you can add that to any frequency token you want to. So if we right click, click type, and click low shelf, you see that we can do it from all the way over here. Now high shelf is the same thing, it's just everything's on the right. So if you notice, exact same, just on the right side. Next we have the peaking, which looks like this. All of your frequency bands 2 through 6 are peaking, and these just allow you to bring up and lower the frequencies of certain ones. Next we have the high pass, which cuts off everything from the left depending on where you drag it. So you can see if I bring this all the way over here, everything to the left of that band is cut off. And low pass is essentially the same thing, just to the right. You can see here. And like everything else, you could adjust the steepness and the bandwidth. And once you have an understanding of these, you'll have an understanding of all these different types of filters as well. Now, how do we actually use this EQ to make things sound good? Well, I actually have a tutorial on vocal processing that goes through everything you need to know for making your vocals sound professional in FL Studio. If you want to watch that video, you can click the icon up here. But just a quick run through for you guys. What I like to do is I like to take the first frequency band, put it on the high pass, and move it up to about 110. So if we listen to that.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes. A lot of the low end that's not necessary is cut out, so it sounds a lot cleaner. If we click before.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
And after.
Test because I'm the best.
It just sounds a little more clean. Another thing I like to do is to keep this on high shelf and then bring the 7 up by a couple of decibels to give the higher treble part of my voice a little more shine.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes. Then what I'll do with the peaking bands is I'll look for frequencies that I don't like, which are some that might sound muddy or nasally. And I go over everything, like I said, in that video. So make sure you go watch it. It's all about how to process your vocals in FL Studio. But I usually just search for really bad sounding frequencies.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes.
Test because I'm the best. Yeah. Test because I'm. Test because I'm.
So around here, I don't like it. So I'm just going to bring this down and cut it out a little bit. And what I might also do is just bring down the bandwidth a little bit so that it's more centered on that frequency. And you can also adjust the bandwidth if you hover over the token and move your scroll wheel on your mouse.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes. And then I'm going to look for some other frequencies that I don't like.
Test because I'm the best.
So down there, it sounds a little more muddy. So I'm going to bring this down here, bring down the bandwidth a little bit. Then if we listen back.
Test because I'm the best. Yes.
Yes. If we compare that before and after, this is before.
Test because I'm the best.
And this is after.
Test because I'm the best. Yeah.
It sounds a lot cleaner. So guys, that's how you use EQ in FL Studio. If this tutorial was helpful for you guys, make sure you leave a like. Go down to the comment section below. Tell me what you want to see next. And if you have any questions, make sure to comment them below. Or you can even DM me on Instagram and Twitter. Those links are in the description. Make sure you subscribe to see more content on FL Studio and being an artist in general. And hit the notification bell to get updated with any new content I might put out. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope you learned something new from this tutorial. I try to keep everything as simple as possible so you guys can understand and become better musicians. So go out there, apply this to your music, shoot me a DM and show me what you got. I love you guys. Let's try to hit 400 subscribers before the end of this month. And remember, don't be afraid to show your genius. Open, everyone gon' listen. Till your time, we gon' beat the competition. This game got a young and new addition. Getting followers like we the new
This my 2020 vision. Yeah, this my 2020 vision.